So you told a little bit about your career when it started as a football player. Now we're going to talk about your time in Blackburn Rovers.
Okay.
And your life there.
Yeah.
Could you tell us a little bit about your career and your life as a football player in this club?
Okay, so I remember I joined Blackburn Rovers at the age of 16, and Kenny Dalglish was a big inspiration for me. So between the ages of 14 and 16, I still wasn't attached to a Premier League or a professional football club. So at that time there, I was in a real fortunate position because I was playing for England, I was one of the best in the country at that age group, so I could go to any club that I wanted to, really. They was all wanting my signature, which was a fantastic position to be in. In fact, I remember very early on that when my phone used to ring at home, my dad always used to say to me, "That's Alex Ferguson on the phone," and it was a joke. And then this one day the phone rang, and my dad went out to answer the phone. I was sat watching TV, and he walked back in and he said, "That was Alex Ferguson." I was like, "Sure, Dad." He said, "Luke, it was Alex Ferguson. He wants to know, will you sign for him?" And I remember that, oh my gosh, you know, he's a super legend, isn't
he? Yeah, best manager in the world.
The best ever. However, I chose to sign for Blackburn Rovers. And the reason I signed for Blackburn Rovers is because Kenny Dalglish was there. And the way he looked after us when we went there as a family, you know, he really invested his time and his effort. I could see that there was a real growing club with great foundations with the youth academy. There really was an inspirational group of people at that time. It was a season that they was looking to win the Premier League, and so I was fortunate. I joined them in the season 96, just after they won the Premiership. So they was at the pinnacle, and the likes of Kenny Dalglish was there, and Alan Shearer, and Chris Sutton, and David Batty, a lot of players that I really respected and looked up to. So I was really privileged that they offered me a professional contract. So I joined them at the age of 16. And at that time, it was called a youth training scheme. It was YTS. Mm. And he was on £40 a week. And he used to clean booths, used to clean toilets. And he used to, if a player of a first team wanted anything, you just did it. You just got it for him.
Yeah.
And it was fantastic because you was made to work hard and play football. So you become more disciplined, and you learn about organisation, you learn about professionalism. You was around so many successful people, yet you just looked up to them and you was their runaround, really. So when I joined there at 16, for me, I'd already lived away from home since the age of 14, so I was used to that, being away from home. And a lot of players found that challenging because we had players from all over the world at that time that was coming into Blackburn Rovers to play for the youth team. Some great players, the likes of Damien Duff, that went on to play for Chelsea, Republic of Ireland.
Yeah.
So some of the players found it quite challenging living away from home because we all lived on the training ground itself. So there'd be 30 plus players all living together. And I'd been used to that kind of environment, and I loved that environment. It was amazing. So I joined there at the age of 16, and really it was all down to the likes of Kenny Dalglish and also Alan Irving, who, you know, he's gone on to have a managerial career, not been as successful as I would have loved him to be, because he's a fantastic guy, phenomenal coach. So they were my reasons for joining the club. So I joined there at the age of 16, and what I found the most challenging of being at Blackburn Rovers was they was the best in the country at that time. So, and I was one of the best in the country at that time for my age group. Yet, you're in an age group, now you've got all these players from all over the world to contend with. So the biggest challenge was trying to break through and get past these players that have got hundreds of league games of experience. Some players like Martin Dahlin, who was coming in, and you know, some world-class players, Lars Bohinen from Norway. They had so many good players, and it was great to be around them. However, it was hard to get past them. That was the biggest challenge.
Yeah. Well, how did it affect you playing with these kind of players? Your mindset and your way of working
as a football player. So being around them types of players was great because you learned from them. You used to, you know, certain players you would watch and you would model them. So someone like Lars Bohinen, he used to stay out after training every day with a tennis ball, doing kick-ups with a tennis ball, and he used to watch that and think, I need to do that if I want to be as good as him.
Mm.
And you also learn from other players that maybe wasn't as professional, that maybe didn't put extra work in, that had good careers but could have had great careers if they had a better focus, a better mindset and had more discipline. So you could learn from the great professionals, you could also learn from the others of maybe what not to do. And sometimes you could get pulled both ways. So sometimes you would behave like them because it was fun, and sometimes you would think, I need to behave more like this player here if I want to really make it. So we were surrounded by great, disciplined people, the best of the best, the Alan Shearers of the world at that time. I was never fortunate enough to play in the first team with him, yet I got to train with him and watch him in training. He would always be out there at the end of the training, practicing his finishing, his shooting. And I can remember one day watching Tim Flowers was in goal and Alan Shearer just boom, boom, goal after goal after goal. It was just fantastic.
Phenomenal players.
Phenomenal, yeah.
One of the best players in UK, Alan Shearer, actually.
Definitely, without doubt. And the best goal scorers of all time.
Yeah, definitely.
A fantastic player.
Both for Blackburn and also for Newcastle.
It's great. Blackburn Rovers won the Premier League, and if it wasn't for someone like him, they wouldn't have won the Premier League. But they played to his strengths. They had Jason Wilcox on the left and Stuart Ripley on the right, just crossing it for him, and he was there every time.
Yeah, I remember that time. It was just very interesting. It was a surprise as well, you know,
it was
the Premier
surprise,
League,
yeah.
Because Manchester United was one of the best clubs, actually, in the 90s.
I think it's possibly the last time, like Leicester City just winning the Premier League, and Blackburn Rovers won it. It was unexpected at the start of that season, you know, and Jack Walker, who owned a football club at that time, put in a lot of investment and really wanted the club to win the Premiership, which they did. It was amazing.